Hare Krishna. Speak in a way that educates and engages, not enrages and estranges. When we speak to people, especially when we have some knowledge, wisdom, experience to share with them, we need to do it in a way that is effective. How do you know whether the speech is effective? It is not just determined by what we speak, but it is also determined by what effect what we speak has on the other people, on the hearers. And that is where austerity of speech is required. In the Bhagavad-Gita in 17:15, when Krishna talks about austerity of speech, it's significant that he doesn't talk about austerity only in terms of being truthful. It's easy to speak lies and seek shortcuts. And it requires courage and conviction to speak the truth. But austerity of speech involves other things also. Krishna says in 17:15, Anudvegakaram Vakyam Satyam Priyahitam Chayat Swadhyaya Bhyasanam Chaiva Vanmayam Tapa Uchyate. That Anudvegakaram Vakyam, speak in a way that does not agitate others. This means that we should speak in a way that is truthful. So, but it is a way that attracts people. Krishna has earlier also said in 3:26, Na buddhi bhedam janayet agyanam karma sanghinam joshayet sarva karmani vidvan yuktah samacharan. So speak in a way that engages people so that they can gradually be elevated on the spiritual journey. Sometimes we may speak the truth, but if we are judgmental in speaking the truth, or even if we come off as judgmental, people may become enraged and they become estranged from the truth. And that if that happens, then our purpose is being defeated. So educate means that we should speak in a way that makes sense to people, and not just intellectual sense, but also emotional sense. And then engages that, inspires them to come closer to the truth. And speaking in this way is austerity of speech. Thank you. Hare Krishna.